Supporting 2 drink minimum through the Amazon link is the next step in the evolution.
Celebrity voice impersonator.
Party! People in the place, the people's going on. It's me. Hey, guess what? It's Fuller House time. Trying to get excited for it. Can't get excited for it because it's Fuller House time. There's no way to get excited for Fuller House time. Like none. But there is something to get excited for. Look at this. When you have a drinking game surrounded you channel focused YouTube VidMe Daily Motion channel and you just don't have a whole bunch of time, get yourself some dailies. Dailies, yes. That's what's on the menu today. Dailies, yes. This is not, they don't advertise. They should advertise. Hey, dailies, you want to advertise on a drinking type YouTube channel? Come on over here to 2 Drink Minimum. We've been doing this for a minute, baby. You can hop on board. We can get this dailies party going. And I can drink a whole bunch of your stuff. And you can pay me for doing it. Or maybe even pay me in dailies. Pay me in dailies. Yes. I don't know. That's my pitch. Are we professional over here? Of course we are. Hey, guess what? It's Fuller House time. Let's do a little housekeeping. First off, if you're watching this on VidMe, you know, or watching this on Riff.tv, even, that's where you're supposed to be watching it. You know what to do. Let's go ahead and skip through. If you're watching this on VidMe, Daily Motion, or YouTube, then guess what? We watch this here via my Netflix account, right? And if you're watching on Riff.tv, all that is a plug-in on your Chrome extension. Right, your Chrome browser, it's an extension that you download, and you can watch it alongside with me on your Netflix account, too. And you can watch it in real time, and you can drink in real time, hence why it's called a real-time review. Yes, but if you're not over there, if you're on VidMe Daily Motion or YouTube, and just download Scare Your Grandpa, that's great, that's fine, too. Press play on whatever device you're watching Netflix on, right, when I say starting right now, and you can watch along with me and keep up. You can keep up. Keep up with the Joneses. You can... keep up, as Bruno Mars would say. And you have to drink as you're watching Fuller House, because it's Fuller House. There's no way to watch Fuller House and not drink, either from depression that you're watching Fuller House, or depression that you're watching Fuller House, or depression that you're watching Fuller House. Hey, guess what? We're getting close to the end of this fucking season, this godforsaken season, even though Netflix didn't forsake it and okayed it for a second godforsaken season. This is episode 10 of Fuller House. This is a giant leap. Episode 10, a giant leap. A Fuller House starts right now. Nope. Oh, I'm gonna try it again. Starts right now. La 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 ha. Whatever happened to my fucking liver? Oh, I've been watching Fuller House. That's why you got some Rosa. Alright. Starring the mom from The View. Co-starring Jodie Sweetin and her tits. And Mugger McMuggerson. Mugger Mick, I've clearly been off TV for the last 20 years. Clearly haven't done even fucking community theater. Haven't even posted a fucking YouTube vlog or anything in 20 fucking years. Clearly I don't belong on a... big operation team show like this. Alright, so anyway, there are rules. There are rules to this drinking game. If we get an audience overreaction, and take a sip. If we get, an audience overreaction, and I actually didn't do this right. Because that was the first audience overreaction. I really didn't do this right. We gotta drink through this. Hold on, I need a spoon.
I'm still here, I'm just getting a spoon. Relax. Relax, kiddies. I didn't know I didn't miss anything super funny, did I? I didn't? That's shocking on this show. Alright, so that's the first one, so. Brain freeze. So, an audience overreaction like that is worth a sip. A new catchphrase like, holy chalupa, is worth a sip. An old catchphrase is worth two. The first actual joke of the show, you finish your drink. And whatever the first infraction is, you finish your drink. So now I gotta finish this frozen delight here. I so didn't do this right. Don't blame me, dailies. I didn't do this right. So I gotta down this and sip something else. He looked at the studio audience. This is why I'm saying the first actual joke of the show, you finish your drink. There ain't no actual jokes in this show. That was another audience overreaction, so I owe two sips after I'm finished with this alcohol cream here. Gee, I wonder if he's an actor or not. Stop looking at the audience! But look at her tits, though. If you were dating those, please believe me, you would need to go to home plate to swing the bat. So I owe four audience reactions now. Alright. Man, that took longer than I thought. That's enough of that! And the brain freeze! And the brain freeze! And the brain freeze! Oh, the brain freeze! Oh, the brain freeze! Oh, the brain freeze! Oh, the brain freeze, alright. Alright, that's okay. I'm so waiting for an actual joke, though. Alright, so reaction! Right after I got over the brain freeze. There's an audience of reaction. Really, they broke up in high school? Didn't they? Didn't, like, prom night? Wasn't there a prom night gimmick? There's another one. I'm surprised that wasn't a whoa, baby! That was almost a joke. That was almost a joke. That was almost a joke. You're trying. You're trying. Come on. Turnover, baby. Come on. And they fucking ruined it. Muggsy McMuggerton. Muggsy McMuggerton fucking fucked it up. Muggsy McMuggerson. They tried to keep. That won't go. An audience overreaction. And then he kissed me. He kissed me in another audience overreaction. This is audience overreaction night. And of course they added them versus the Dodgers. Hey, let me buy your children's love with my credit card. Good job there, veterinary boy. Stephanie's shirt could have been lower. We all know that. They're the co-stars of the show. Come on, let's go. Especially because it's not your credit card. Can't see your ID. You forgot the jersey, you knucklehead. Freaking fly in here. Yeah, right across his big ass head. Knock him the fuck out. Giant headed, mugging, overacting motherfucker. God. I mean, I love kids though. Ding. For being a meanie. Still waiting for that actual good joke. They came close. They came super close. They came super close. By the way, I have a feeling they spent their entire budget on this one. Or maybe, maybe... They actually commandeered fucking Giant Stadium for this shit. This show sucks! Isn't she supposed to have a singing career or try to have a singing career or something? Jodie Sweetin? The last time I heard her sing was like I saw the sign with the chick from the practice. I need to drink my way through this. There's an old catchphrase! That's worked too. And all that was on a fucking blue screen? They did that part on a fucking blue screen? The kiss cam, by the way, fucking sucks. Kiss cam is fucking awful. Fuck the kiss cam. Yes.
Oh, brain freeze, come on.
Oh, I hate this show so much. I just need something funny to actually happen. I just need something funny to actually happen. I hate this show so much. I hate this show so much. I hate the 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 show so much. Thank you, Carly Penguin, again. Muggsy McMuggserson. Yeah, she belongs in Idaho. Audience overreaction! Audience overreaction! Still waiting for an actual joke. Still waiting for an actual freaking joke. Stick to voice acting, Steve! Fucking fly. The most interesting thing that's happened in the last half hour is me chasing and killing that fly. I want you to know that, Netflix. I want you to know that, Fuller House cast and crew. And San Francisco Giants. If I liked baseball at all, I'd really hate this episode. Green screens. More green screens. That fucking hair. That fucking hair. I think he knew that his forehead was gonna get too big. Thank you.
fourth Wally. I see what they're doing here. I see what they're trying to do here. Again, there are sparks on this show where it almost feels like they're trying to make it a good sitcom. They're actually trying to make an effort. I did that once. I did that in high school. I did that once. I was a sophomore. She was a freshman. We were invited over to somebody's birthday party. The other guy she was interested in was like, let's fucking go outside. He was a freshman too. I was like, fine, let's fucking go outside. So he fucking goes outside. I slam and lock the door behind him. Ha! Because he's a fucking idiot. That's why. And I think he's still a fucking idiot. Audience super overreaction. All right, more audience overreactions. Can this show be over yet? Not this episode, this show. Can we finish with this fucking season? All goddamn ready? Can we Dr. Kevorkian this shit already? Like there were sparks on it. It felt like it was trying. There were certain times where it tried. You had the Macy Gray episode, and it was like, come on, baby. It was trying to turn over. It almost felt like this episode was kind of like that. Just long stretches of fucking boredom. Then it tries. And then nothing. And then it fucking falls flat. And then the biggest joke that they have is the two dudes kissing, which was not as funny as my story about me having the fucking Neanderthal asshole fucking locked out of the fucking party because he was fucking dumbass and I was smarter than him. Ha 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 ha. Anyway. This show goes on for far too long. It does. It's fucking. Is it really just a half hour? Oh god. And it's a full half hour too. Like it's not even just the 22 minutes. Oh, it's such a slog. Oh, but the good news is that we're almost finished. And party people, we are almost finished with this particular episode. But before we go, I need you to tell me what you think about this episode down there in the comment section. Do you actually care about Steve and super tall Mick Buffont, Dr. Dude, versus the mommy, mom girl? Like, eh. Do you care about that? What is this? Do you care about that love triangle at all? I don't. Like the only time that love triangle would seem interesting to me is if they did a Pornhub version, the porn parody version of it, and they just did dot, and then it's actually just three-way. and even then, it would only be interesting if the actress managed to keep the Candace Cameron momness throughout the whole scene. Oh my gosh, I can't believe this is happening to me. That would be funny. I'd watch that. Come on, poor parody producers. You just did a fucking Power Rangers one. I know you come up with this one. This show sucks. They need to display, I keep telling them every episode, they need to display Stephanie Tanner's tits a lot more than they have been. Good part about this episode is that, actually no, this wasn't really a good part because we got a lot of Muggy McMuggerson. We got a lot of Big Head McMuggerson. Hey, at least the kid actor, the boy kid actor, got to get his little TV girlfriend, up to the bleachers and probably spark something backstage because it's 12 years old. Like that shit just in close proximity. Like that shit happens all the time. Other than that, boy oh boy. And Steve, stick to voice acting, buddy. Like you were either phoning it in or didn't have it anymore. Like that's just come on, just do the Aladdin voice. Do it, I'll show you the world. Come on. And then proceed to go away where you were before. Like just pop up whenever Aladdin hits his 30th, 35th, 40th, you know, every 5 years for a seminal Aladdin anniversary, then and bye. Pardon me. Oh, at least we didn't get to see too much of the fucking baby. That was good. It was super mommy focused. And I'm not. At least it wasn't entirely focused on fucking Kimmy and the fucking big head kid entirely. Like, they were in it. Like, structurally, the way they wrote it included everybody, and that was good. Everybody played a relatively equal part in the episode. It was more of an ensemble episode. Structurally, that's great. That's how you're supposed to write stuff. But have better characters. So that I give a damn. So, like, have more three-dimensional characters so that I actually care whether or not they're represented in the episode or not. I just otherwise, I'm just sitting here like, is it over? Can I finish my drink now? I can't. Oh, goody. Part of you will tell me what you think about it down there in the comment section, though. Like, share, subscribe. Do me a favor on your way out of this. If you're watching this on VidMe, there's a little button down there below the video that says tip this creator or contribute to the creator. Something about the creator. You can do that and you help keep the lights on at the party. Put in a little tip in the tip jar. You can also keep the lights going, lights on at the party, going at the party, whatever at the party, by clicking the links in the description. Amazon, Groupon, eBay, doing all that stuff to help keep the lights on at the party. Get yourself two drink minimum swag on your way out. Help keep the lights on at the party. And all this keeping the lights on at the party, boy. I'm telling you, it ain't bad. Unlike this show. Boom. Boom. Sit like city, bitch.